There's a recent discussion on Christian X, formerly Twitter, concerning baptism. While some believe baptism involves immersion, many do not identify baptism with water. Some say baptism means salvation, while others don't believe that baptism saves. Some view baptism as a symbol and even consider it idolatry. This conversation started from an X space, a live audio conversation on the microblogging platform, on the topic of the non-necessity of the sacraments, baptism and communion. Many men of God from Nigeria contributed to the discussion, including Apostle Emmanuel Iren. There's been a lot of debate and backlash. Let us listen to the key highlights from the space.
If the position that Apostle Emmanuel Iren and some people that have observed on Twitter is to be true, that what Jesus commanded the disciples was that they should baptize in the Holy Spirit, there would have not been any need for Peter to say they just received the Holy Spirit just as we have, go baptize them with water. So the fact that Peter still recommended, still ordered that they be baptized with water, even after being filled, being baptized by the Holy Spirit, conclusively proves that Jesus indeed meant that they should go into the world and baptize people with water by immersion.
So baptism could not mean, in the sense that Pastor Aaron was speaking about it, that it's in that sense. It would definitely mean baptism by water, because this Acts chapter 9, verse 17 and 18, earlier talked about that it's not really good baptism in that sense.
Is it the unanimous agreement of the people on this life that baptism, water baptism, saves?
It's not my position, it's the position of the apostles. Peter clearly says that this baptism that now saves you is an appeal of a clear conscience to God. Water baptism, in that it is a confession. The same way our confessions save us, baptism saves us.
Christ himself was talking about water baptism. The witness of the church for 2,000 years has always interpreted Matthew 28 as water baptism. There are people who have to preach on soteriology and then will disparage baptism on the long run. And I'm like, that's poor homiletics. You don't, even if you're teaching on the atoning sacrifice of Christ, you don't have to disparage baptism to do that. There are only two people, I think, that teach this thing. One of them is Ibel Damida.
The host of that discussion cited that misleading teaching on baptism started from Dr. Ibel Damida. Let us watch Pastor Ibel Damida's reaction to such a point of view in a previous sermon, and also a message on baptism by Apostle Iren that will fully explain what he meant in his contribution to that interaction.
They said Dr. Damina is heretic. He said baptism is not for Christians. Well, I didn't say baptism is not for Christians. I said Christians are baptized. A child of God is already baptized in Christ. So therefore, he doesn't need another baptism. The day you receive Jesus, you are baptized into Christ. That one baptism is enough.
You know, in water baptism, man of God, no matter how great, still man, immerses you in water, you know, immerses you in water, brings you out. But then you see something in 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Turn your Bibles, 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Verse 13. I'm going to go ahead and read, because this is just preamble. It says, for by one spirit, look at this. Read it together, one, two, go. Hold on. Did he say by one swimming pool? Hold on, hold on. So he said by one what?
Spirit.
Pay attention. So there is a baptism of the spirit. And whether it stands in lieu of water baptism or not, we will identify. Same text that tells us circumcision was a symbol tells us about baptism. Colossians 2:11 tells us about circumcision, and verse 12 tells us about baptism. So Colossians chapter 2 verse 12, now it says, buried with him in baptism, in which you also are raised with him through faith in the working of God who raised him from the dead. When you read this, tell me, should water baptism come to your mind? He's talking about something else. Baptism is a supernatural operation by which we all become beneficiaries of Christ's redemptive work. If you feel that what Christ did benefits you, know for sure that that's only possible because of baptism. By the Spirit, we have all been immersed into one body. All that happened to Christ is as though it happened to all men. We died in him. We were buried in him. We were raised together with him. We reign with him. Glory to God. Now that's baptism. And that's what water baptism was to foreshadow. Many people, when they say water and spirit, they think he was talking about water baptism, which is silly. Water was symbolic of the spirit. Now you have to see baptism for what it was. It was a strategy for finding the Messiah. Someone put it beautifully, and it's so true. He said, you will notice that after John the Baptist identified the Messiah through baptism, there's no record of him baptizing anyone anymore. Because his true mission was to point people to the person who takes away sins. If water baptism was really about sin and repentance, why would he stop after he had found the Messiah? Because his true assignment was to point and say, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And water baptism was just a strategy to find that person who takes away. Listen, if he thought water baptism took away sins or was actually efficacious for cleansing, he wouldn't have stopped. Bible made sure to tell us Jesus never baptized anyone with water. Listen, the person who started water baptism expected his baptism to fade away. If you believe that water baptism is for today, then you can't believe in Paul. Because it is either what Paul said is correct, or he is very much a heretic for saying this. In 1 Corinthians 1:14, he said, I thank my God I baptized none of you. This is a church. He's talking to a church historically that had somewhere around 5,000 members. And he said, I thank God. So that means maybe their salvation should be called to question. Since water baptism must come with salvation. Baptism of water was just a story. It was the salvation story. If water baptism was about repentance from sin, why was Jesus baptized? Just imagine Jesus on the cross and the other guy on the cross beside him say, remember me in paradise. And Jesus said, no swimming pool here. Sorry, you cannot be saved. The baptism of the Holy Spirit and fire. It's salvation. That's what it is. The moment you believe and you are saved, you have received that baptism. Then with you, with this Holy Spirit you have, you still carry yourself and enter water. Next time, just carry soap. Make it complete. Carry sponge.